Hey guys, how's it going? Today, let's take a test drive in the 1990 Chevrolet Caprice Classic. I already have a full in-depth review and tour of this vehicle on my channel. So if you want to see a little bit more in-depth, I'll post the video below and you can check that out. It's going to be a combination of first and third person views. We'll go over some of the performance data and see how it sounds. And I'll demonstrate a few of the features on the interior and exterior as we drive. And today, I'm at All City Auto Sales in Indian Trail, North Carolina. So let's go ahead and get started. Has a blue cloth interior. And my tripod set up in the rear for the third person clips. $79,000 original miles. Fires right up. Has a 5-liter V8. All right. Let's go ahead and get started, shall we? Pardon a little bit of the camera lean. This is the only way I can affix the tripod steadily in the vehicle. Acceleration. Very smooth power band. It's a 4-speed automatic transmission. Very easy to steer. Liter V8s haven't gotten a whole lot of praise as being the most efficient when it comes to power and stuff, but this V8 and this Caprice, I'm actually pretty impressed. It's probably not going to win a whole lot of races off the line, but it's definitely plenty of adequate power whenever you need it. It has a really nice, deep, burly sound to it too. It just feels like you're driving a little bit of substance. Rides like a dream. The Caprice has 170 horsepower at 4,400 RPM, 225 foot-pounds of torque at 2,400 RPM. So you have a little bit of extra torque in the low RPMs to make up for the less horsepower. Radio takes a little bit of leaning forward to access. Same thing with the climate control. But they are fairly simple to use. Temperature. Now for the first person clips, I'll show you some of the interior lighting as it's getting dusk. And you'll be able to see some of the instrumentation. Love the sound of this car. It's got a very big stance on the road. It is such a comfortable car from the driver's point of view. I know I've mentioned several things about it from now, but it's really hard to appreciate until you actually drive one for yourself. It's not the best road handler either. A lot of body rolls in the turns. Definitely made to be more of a cruising vehicle. See if we can get a little bit of an acceleration pass. Make sure the coast is clear. Definitely not bad. Easily accessible power controls. Windows you have to maybe move up a little bit, but fairly accessible. All of that length and stuff that I was mentioning is just because it's a bigger car, obviously. Very nice. Alrighty. Hope you guys enjoyed this detailed test drive of the 1990 Chevrolet Caprice Classic. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.